leads right into the next one. Communicate with an ADHD coach. I imagine a coach like yourself would work with them to set these deadlines.
Absolutely. Well, it's just like you said in your introduction, you want to help move them through this much more quickly. And at first, the coach might set up some outside structures and maybe give you some tasks like just color code your date book for a week or use your phone for a week to make a phone call. I mean, to keep your schedule. And then slowly over time, you integrate this so that you're managing it yourself.
And so you can experience some success at these smaller tasks. I would assume their confidence starts building a little bit where it's been kind of dented to that point, right?
Right, right. Wow. And so, and really big is reward yourself when you achieve a task. So many times people with ADHD are really working very hard to try to keep in control and keep organized. People on the outside perceive them as lazy or disorganized or something, but actually a person with ADHD is working very hard to manage. And so reward yourself when you do something right.
So make a little, maybe make a list of the things and give yourself, I think it would always involve frozen yogurt in my case. Speaking of which, you said admit mistakes and laugh at yourself.
That's right. That's right. Don't take it so seriously. You know, own it. Yeah, okay, I have this challenge, and this is what I'm going to do to make it better. And this is what I've learned to do to help myself. And if somebody gets on you because you missed a date, say, there it is, ADD again, and to work with it. But, you know, don't get so uptight about it. Just let it go, and you'll actually find yourself flowing with it a little bit more.
So can we talk a little bit about what are some reasonable things employers can do? I know you've already sort of touched on it, but some of the reasonable things to ask for and that they can do?
Well, first of all, you need to understand that employers are required to, if they have 15 people or more, by the ADA, American Disabilities Act, they are required to make reasonable accommodations. That means accommodations that are not going to be too out of the ordinary or too expensive to do work, but accommodates or helps the person be more effective as a worker. So it might be giving you a space or an office where you can shut the door. It might be giving you a fan. It might be helping coach you on your deadlines and reminding you of your deadlines, but letting that person have the freedom to work through to get to that deadline in their own way and pace.
Do they
don't micromanage.
Say that again?
And don't micromanage.
Do they sometimes maybe assign a mentor or somebody for the person to work with?
Right. And that's where a good supervisor will see that a person would benefit to being with somebody more structured. Also, accommodations can be as simple as allowing that person to come in early or stay late so that they can work in a quieter time pace or time slot. It might be involving not being too upset at them if they turn off their ringer for certain hours so they can concentrate, or putting a note, do not disturb sign on the door.
Is there any, now you said about coming in late or leaving, whatever. I have clients that call themselves procrastinators. Is there any relationship between procrastination and ADHD, or are they totally separate from each other and have nothing to do with it?
People with ADHD have a very difficult time starting projects. They get into anxiety and fear that they're not going to be able to complete the task, and so they don't even begin the task. And so sometimes they need that tension of the deadline, and they work best with deadlines. That's when the creative juices flow. But you can't rely on that as your method for motivating yourself. You have to really maybe talk out loud with somebody, you know, your plan and what you're going to do, your initial steps to get a project going.
Yeah, I don't have it with me, but I read this one study where progressively from just saying something's a good idea to declaring that you're going to do it, to telling another person, to asking that person to hold you accountable. The percentage of success goes from 5% to something like 95%.
Yes, right.
Again, is that amazing?
That is. It's so true. So if you commit verbally to writing it down, first of all, writing it down, and then verbally sharing it with somebody, it's a great way to get yourself motivated and getting going. And you do commit.
I would think headphones would also help the distraction, right? The sound, they kill out the sound.
The headphones are a great use of a simple costing accommodation.
So could we talk a little bit about some of the resources that are available? I know that you, in the green room, you had a few books there. Can you talk about, now we're showing your contact information, so if they want to directly ask you, I'm sure they
can. Well, there's a classic Bible, Driven to Distraction, and I think there is a sequel to that book as well now. There is adult ADD books in the workplace, working with adult ADHD or ADD in the workplace. There's also in every community of substantial size an organization called CHAD. And
CHAD?
CHAD.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And CHAD is kind of a grassroots but well-organized organization where you can have groups and you can talk about your experiences and talk about your different medications that you might be involved in and coping strategies to working with that. And it's on the website. You can find your local chapter of that.
I was thinking if people meet in a group, they could hold each other accountable. We have in careers, we have a concept called success team, where you say what you're going to do for the week and you tell somebody else, and then you're supposed to say what happened or what stood in the way. I guess it would work there too, huh?
That's a very tried and true method. Yep.
Yeah. So, is there much, we only have like about 30 seconds, but is there much connection between learning issues and ADHD, or are they kind
of? Actually, very tied. About 50% of most people that have ADHD also have some type of learning disability.
So and if they're dealing with the ADHD, they're also helping themselves with the learning issues and with the procrastination. Okay. You know, you do very important work, and
thank
I want to thank you on behalf of all the people that struggle with this, that you help them with that. You have a lot to be proud of.
Thank you very much, Steve.
It's
a pleasure to share.
And thank you for watching the show. If you have any questions about jobs and careers, questions about the show, feel free to contact me at steve@bayareacareercoach.com. Again, it's steve@bayareacareercoach.com. Do check out the website. You'll find the 12 keys to getting a great job. Sign up for my career newsletter there. Find out about the career coaching I do. Watch some of the past episodes of this show, and this one will be up there soon. And also, I have the contact information for everybody who's been on the show, so if you want to contact Margaret, they can, right? And my website is www.bayareacareercoach.com. Again, it's www.bayareacareercoach.com. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you next time on You're Hired. And thank you so much.
Thank you, Steve.
You know, really, I meant it. I think the work you do, I mean, these people have to feel so isolated in what they're doing.